Hello everyone, and welcome back to Gage Crafts. I'm Sarah Scully, and today I'm coming to you with another great recipe. It's going to be a soup recipe for winter. As you can see, it's kind of a gray day out there in mid-November, and so it's always nice to have a nice hot bowl of soup in the evening to enjoy. Before we get into that recipe though, I want to make a special announcement and wish ourselves and you guys a happy YouTubeiversary. We've had the channel going now for 1 year, and we've had such an awesome time doing it and interacting with everybody. So we have a special anniversary episode that we have planned for next week, and I'll tell you about that more at the end of this episode. So to get back to the soup, this is a great soup recipe for wintertime. It's hearty and warming and satisfying, and it's pretty healthy. There's not a lot of, you know, excess fat or anything like that in it. It's gluten-free vegan for those of you who are following either of those diets or have those dietary needs. And it also makes it a pretty good one to take to, you know, potluck dinners or that kind of thing. It's economical. None of the ingredients are particularly expensive. And so let's get into the actual recipe itself. And as usual, the full details step-by-step are going to be on the blog, and so I'll link to that in the show notes below this video so you can follow it step-by-step. But I'll give you an overview. So the main ingredients are sweet potatoes, onions, there's a bit of ginger, some other spices, tomato juice for some acid, and one secret ingredient, peanut butter. And when I first heard about this soup, I thought, what a weird combination. Tomato juice and peanut butter, right? It doesn't exactly sound like something you would want to have. But with the sweet potatoes and the other starchy vegetables that are in this and all the spices, it's really an amazing combination. Now, I should mention that this recipe is an adaptation, and I'll give full credit to the original cookbook, but this is a West African recipe. And I make mine slightly different than the original cookbook, so I feel pretty good reposting this. I've simplified it a little bit. So these flavor combinations are not ones that you see or typically experience in Western cuisine, and that's what makes this soup so fun, right? You're stuck in a rut. You've had whatever it is, chili or potato leek soup or chicken noodle soup for however many days, and you know, you're getting tired of it and you want something different, but you still want that nice warm bowl of satisfying, delicious soup. This is a great one to throw into your rotation, and it's pretty easy to make. So an overview of the recipe is that you take those starchy vegetables, your sweet potatoes, your onions, it also has carrots in it, and you're gonna cook those in your liquid for the recipe until those are all nice and soft. You're gonna whiz them up and blend them with an immersion blender until your soup is nice and creamy. You're gonna add in a few more spices, and then you're gonna add in the peanut butter towards the end of the cooking process, and that is just gonna give it a rich, nutty, satiny, umami, beautiful flavor. And it's interesting because this soup, if you get the proportions right, and I've cooked it a number of times, so I'm pretty happy with the proportions I have in my version. If you get the proportions right, it doesn't really taste like peanuts per se. There's just this lovely rich undertone, and so you're eating the soup and you're thinking, okay, it's orange, it's obviously, you know, sweet potato carrot soup, but what is that other thing under there? And it's a nice surprise. Obviously, don't surprise your friends if they have a nut allergy. Tell them that it's peanuts. But it's a lovely taste, and I encourage you to try it, even if it sounds a little weird. I think you'll really like it. This recipe goes wonderfully with our recipe for maple cornbread, Vermont maple cornbread, and that's one of the first videos I did on the channel. So I'll link to that in the show notes as well, and you can check that one out. The maple cornbread is quick and easy. It's a quick bread recipe, so it's sort of like making muffins. It goes together quite quickly, and then you just cook it in a cast iron skillet in the oven. And again, it's a lovely sweet accompaniment to a savory, spicy dish. So I encourage you to check that one out as well. If you do make any of our recipes, as always, I would love to know what you think of them. So leave us a comment or send us an email. That would be great to find out what you think of these recipes. Or if you have other versions of things, or you know, if you make them a slightly different way. I love comparing notes with other cooks. So, yeah, let us know. So I promised a special episode next week, and I promised to tell you more about that at the end of this video. So I had gotten this idea from watching some other YouTube channels and podcasts, and often people will do Q&A sessions with their audiences, and I love that idea. Over the last 12 months, we've been slowly building up our audience. Thank you to the new subscribers who have joined us in the past month. We've had a little bump in subscriptions, and I really appreciate that. And, you know, I would love to welcome you all by asking what you're interested in. So ask us a question, whether it's about a previous episode that you watched, or maybe it's about some related topic. We do post on a range of things, including cooking, gardening, fiber arts, and brewing. So you can ask us about any of those. Life in Vermont, anything that's on your mind. I'd love to know more about that and to share more about our experience with you through that Q&A format. Rick is going to be back on the channel with me to answer your questions, so feel free to ask brewing questions or anything else that you're interested in. He also enjoys photography a lot. We haven't really talked about that, but if you follow him on Instagram, that's another great one. So that'd be a great topic to discuss. But yeah, any topic that you're interested in, we would love to hear from you. So you can participate in this episode either by leaving a comment here on our channel. You can send us an email. You can contact us through YouTube. Or you can go on our website and send us an email that way or post to our blog. And I'll also be putting a call out on our other social media channels on Instagram and Facebook, so you can, of course, ask us questions there. I'm going to leave this open probably until Friday, and then we'll gather together your questions and answer them for next week's video. So look for that next Monday. Thanks again for joining me, and don't forget to hit subscribe if you haven't done that already, and we'll see you again in a week. Have a wonderful time crafting, doing whatever you do, and I hope the weather is good for you wherever you are. If not, make that yummy soup and enjoy the warmth that it'll bring you. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Cheers.